Y'all ready for this?
Hey everyone, welcome to Subscribers League. My name is Rev Trev, and I took this year to focus in on fantasy football content. And I've been playing for fantasy football for over 20 years. I know some things, so I wanted to share some of those insights to help you to compete, to contend, and to win a championship. And so I hope that your team's doing well. I hope you've learned a lot from this channel. I just decided, hey, I'm going to take some people who are subscribers to my channel. I'm going to make a fantasy football league. We're going to report on what's going on. We're going to do some fantasy football advice while we do that. So the big news this weekend is injuries. Again, this has just been a crazy year with injuries. Cook's out for a while. McCaffrey's done again for the year. So Hubbard, and if you can get Madison, start him every week. He could win you your league. Now, as long as Cook is out, you know, that's all the thing. But anyways, there's Swift is down. Get Jamal Williams. Like, these are three key running backs at week 12 going into week 13 that you need to pick up and get on your rosters. These guys are going to put up some monster points. In the NFL, Thanksgiving weekend for the States, and man alive, this was absolutely nuts. That game, that Raiders vs. Cowboys game, coming down to the wire. What a game. Derek Carr looked elite. Now, I know he normally doesn't look elite every time, but if every time he scores, throws over 300 passing yards, they end up winning the game. So he was on fire. Jacobs was on point. It was just a great game. Dak Prescott ended up having a really good day, even though I felt like the Cowboys really struggled. Now, granted, they were missing Lamb and Cooper Kupp. Not Cooper Kupp, I'm sorry, Amari Rodgers, and then that the game against the Bears, as you know, like many of you have heard this already, but I'm in a survivor pool, and it's this really gracious survivor pool, three strikes and you're out. I was first place for forever, and then I lost Buffalo, lost to Jacksonville. Remember that week, I picked Buffalo, and then I also picked Tennessee over the Texans, and the Texans had an amazing week, and so I'm down on my wire. I picked the Bears over the Lions, and when the Bears were kicking the field goal, I'm like thinking, is this going to be a double doink? Because like I don't know about you, but I don't trust the Bears kickers, and I'm a Packers fan where Mason Crosby just missed his ninth field goal, leading the league, and I'm still nervous about the Bears. Anyways. What a game to win in the way I was able to win that Survivor League. My Packers are on a roll. I don't know how Stafford played. He was really injured. I guess Rodgers, his toe, because of a COVID injury. Oh my goodness, what a gong show. He literally couldn't feel one of his toes. They injected shots so he could not feel his toe. And the defense came up huge. OBJ had a monster game. He didn't look great. There was moments where he got behind us, and I don't know. He had a good week fantasy-wise, 14 points, I think it was. But the Packers, are we not the best team in football? Like, I think, I predicted we were going to win the Super Bowl, but like, the more I watch this team, the more I think that. And then if we get healthy and we get Bacchiardi, and Jair Alexander, Za'Darius Smith back. Like, this team's dangerous. It's already dangerous, and I just can't see us not winning the Super Bowl. I know that we've struggled. We haven't played perfect football. No Aaron Jones. Like, Aaron Jones came back, didn't play great. Dylan is a monster. Anyways, it's not a show about the Packers, but just pumped about what's going on there. Okay, let's dive into it. This is these times, though, when it comes to fantasy football, you want to do one thing. You want to be picking up guys, your backups to studs right now, because when a guy like Jamal Williams now is playing, or Hubbard is playing, or especially Madison is playing. If Pollard is available in your leagues, you should have him on your roster just in case. Because Pollard looks better than Zeke. But anyways, that's another story for another day. Javonte Williams should be on your roster. Like, these are some of the guys you want to get going because you never know what's going to happen. CEH is back from an injury. Looks like he's solid and good. But get that Darnell Williams on your team. Those are some of those things that could make differences going into the playoffs, especially if someone gets hurt. And you're going to be good to go. Okay, let's dive into last week. Starting with my matchup against BWG. Hammer got hammered by RevTrev. Yours truly. 34-point blowout. Blowout of the week. Now, in Hammer's defense, literally his whole team failed him. Like, Godwin was terrible. Metcalf's terrible. Dak Prescott was the only good thing on his roster, and I just had a solid week considering some of the matchups. I had the second highest point total of the week, so that also doesn't go well. But only when you only score 79 on two quarterback league, that's tough. Speaking of not scoring very much, the lowest scoring team in the league was Stuart Dixon's number one team, the VI Raiders, loses. And not only loses, gets destroyed because he only had 72 fantasy points, almost 73. Let's give you a little bit of credit. 72.96 to Brian's fantasy football team, 105, 73 almost. And then, oh my goodness, so that was a massive blowout. Well done, Brian. VI Raiders, listen, your team absolutely failed you. Come on, man. Like, we're talking Lamar Jackson was garbage. Mahomes was on bye week. You didn't even start in second quarterback. What is wrong with you? 17 points by Williams from Denver. Okay, you kind of saved yourself there. Okay, so, but Swift got injured, 0.9. I mean, you're not going to win when that happens. He even had Jalen Hurts, who had a terrible, terrible week, and he still destroyed you. Okay, B-Pack loses to Vexa. Oh, Vexa! You're on a two-game winning streak, bro. Well done. 101-94. What? 10th on a roll? Are you kidding me? Are you going to make the playoffs? There's a dogfight for the final spot there. And then let's move over to Peter's playoff bound. 103-81. Destroys Chad's battery. And man alive, 81 points. Like, what are with these low scores? Let's just look. Who failed you here? So you had Herbert, who had a decent week, and Cousins, okay. But then, Noah Fant, Montgomery. Oh, you started CeeDee Lamb, dude. You started CeeDee Lamb and you didn't play? Carolina defense against Miami got three for you? Oh, Elijah Moore, that everyone's talking about, this is going to be amazing. This rookie guy, you got to start. 5 points? No, it's over. It's over, man, when that happens. So you dropped down fifth. Mr. Rogers' neighbor, Derek, you had a good week of 101. You would have beat a lot of teams this week, but you ended up playing the number one scoring team in fantasy. Underdogs, who's trying to make the playoffs, needs the win, gets out there, 115 fantasy points by him. Let's just quickly look at his team. Carson Wentz, Garoppolo, and then what? Oh, he had Patterson, Cordell. They call him Scordell. He's so good. Buffalo had 11 fantasy points. Gallup had 10. Jacobs had 17. You started Matt Breida. Good work, man. 11 points. Man, that was a solid, solid win. And even though he had Russell Wilson, Josh Allen, who had some decent points, his team failed him. Nick Chubb just couldn't do it. Okay, so as you can see here, there is 7 teams that have made the playoffs. There's only one spot left. My team being the last one to make the playoffs. Now it's all about positioning and all that kind of stuff. But Hammer, Underdogs, and Vexa are all fighting for that last playoff spot. They're only one game out. So these next 2 weeks are absolutely crucial. Now let's go to next week's results, okay? Or standings or matchups, I should say. So I'm playing B-Pack. That's a big Packer versus Packer fan. Second versus seventh going at it. fantasy football teams playing BWG. That's a big one. Didn't you guys just play each other? No, I played you. Okay, yeah, sorry. Raiders is playing Underdogs. Oh my goodness, 1 versus 9. And then Vexa is 10th playing 3rd. Oh, yeah, this is not good. So maybe this, yeah, that's not good. And then Battery and Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, 4 versus 5. Wow. So there's a lot going on this weekend. This weekend's such an important weekend. And then it looks like it's going to come down to the wire in this league. So hope you're enjoying these. Hope that you take some time to like and make some comments if you want. Subscribe, share this stuff with your friends. I'd love that. Anyways, have a great night. And I just want to let you know, I want to help you to compete, to contend, and to win a championship.